My name is Li Sheng Wang. We are in the UMass Amherst, and I'm working in Professor Rotero's group. So I'm going to be the fourth year for the PhD program. So my research is about generating functional biomaterials specific for protein-based thin film or coatings.
This is the spin coater, and we usually use silicon wafer as a substrate for deposit the proteins.
I'm an international student from Taiwan, and I studied my bachelor degree in chemistry, so that's why that's kind of my background. But actually, I changed my specialty from physical chem, analytical chem, and right now like material scientist. To me, like doing science is not about what you do; it's about how you do it. When I found I really interested in science is when I do the independent study in college, and I found that doing research is very different from learning things from the textbook, which I don't like, because everyone tries to tell you that those things everybody knows. So doing research is different. You need to be creative. You need to use your imagination, and you need to do something different. We all want to create some material that is healthy for the environment. So the best candidate will be the material come from the environment. So nowadays we use a lot of polymer or petroleum related material, but actually in nature we can produce polymer, which is proteins. So no, we don't involve any organic reaction in this process. We just purchase some protein powder, dissolve them in water, and then deposit them onto like substrates. And we use an instrument called nano-imprinter that can provide heat and pressure at the same time to those material. So after you do the processing, the film can be stable. It won't dissolve in water. So that's how we usually to generate those protein films. What's the application about this? So far, we're focusing on like bioapplication. So if you make a film based on those proteins, you can choose different protein precursor because they have different properties. So you can generalize different property of the film and use them to culture cells and control cell behavior. So you can use it for tissue engineering, wound healing, depends on what kind of drug you want to incorporate into those films. People like to emphasize scientific method. So that's the process. You have a hypothesis, you design experiment, and you get a result. That's how people do experiment, like doing science in different areas. They are doing the same thing. So that's very good. And no matter in what area, they all require you to have some creativity. So that's what I think is very important and what makes me interested, because you can use your imagination, you can use your creativity. There are a lot of space for you to do it, and especially you can do something different from the others.